Welcome back to Steve Robb Reviews. Today's review is going to, well, I'm going way out on a limb here. I'm going to tell you what the best digital multimeter is. The only multimeter that I will recommend to the regular do-it-yourselfer. If you're somebody that's not really that up on how to do electrical testing, you just want to do some testing around your house, you've got maybe like a receptacle outlet that's not working and you just want to test it, very basic testing, well, you can go buy yourself a cheap $4 meter, or you can buy one of these. And I'm going to show you what I think is the best meter in my experience, because I've had my share of, let's say, gaffes by using a $3 meter. So let's get over to the bench. Let's take a look. Well, let's start off right here. And these are the meters I have and meter attachments. Some I use for AC, some I use for DC. But AC clamp meter, I tell you what, this is the only one that I'll buy. This is the only one that I've used, and this is the only one that I like. It only does AC, but it's awesome. This one here, I'm not going to say nothing about it right now, but this is awesome. This is the first meter I ever bought. And I bought this one next. This is a high level meter here. This is like a really, really good meter. You know, the Fluke 287. It's quite expensive, but if you're going to do some interesting electrical testing, this is the meter. But this here is another AC DC clamp meter. This is just awesome, but I can't get the resolution down really fine on this particular one, and you don't really buy this to get fine resolution. And as you can see, so far everything is yellow, right? And everything is Fluke. So I mean, this is just the temperature gauge, and this is a distance meter, Fluke. So what are these two doing here? Well, I'll tell you something. To measure DC amperage with this, well, you can see that. See that size hole there? Well, it's only good for like small battery cables. Doesn't really work on most automotive except a small wire. And you know, like that hole there is about maybe 7/16. So this is just an awesome meter. I really like this one, and I highly recommend it. It's not a Fluke, but to buy the high resolution clamp meter in Fluke for DC is like right out of my price range. So and then this one here is actually a cheapie, and it is another awesome meter. Now the reason why I got this one, well, you can see it's got a bigger clamp, and I could do DC. Now I can't do DC with this one here, but I can do it with this one and this one here. Now I just want to put up a little bit of a thumbnail here first. So this is my buddy Terry's channel, and this is a video he did a little while ago, a couple of years ago, and he was talking about the charging circuit on the tractor. And while I was talking to him in the comments there about, I was checking my Kubota tractor with my meter, and it was showing like 16 volts. And that's with the tractor off, not with it running. So I just finished running the tractor, and I test it, and it's 16 volts, something wrong here, right? Well, it turns out I was using one of these meters. Now check this baby out. Now this is a meter that you could like most likely buy anywhere in America. And you know, I took that meter and I chucked it right in the garbage, because you know, I've had my fair share of buying, you know, like these really cheap low-cost meters you just figure you're going to use for backup. Well, that thing threw me for a loop so far when I started reading this high voltage that I thought, okay, there's something wrong. So what did I do? Next time I went up to my camp, I took this one with me. And everything in that tractor is perfect. There's nothing wrong with it. Now, I'm saying, for the money, this here, the Fluke 114, is the best meter for your regular homeowner. It does not check amperage. You can test continuity. You can, like, this is a great meter, but it doesn't check amperage, and that's fine. It'll check everything else, and for most homeowners, it's fine. This is like bulletproof, rock solid. It's not, you're not going to get this for $3-4, I guarantee you. I don't know what the prices were. This meter here goes back with me, got to be 30 years or more. Really don't have any of these meters that I've owned in less than 10 years. But this one here, the main feature why I like this is when you turn it to this setting here, it'll automatically switch to AC or DC for you, whatever you're checking. So you don't have to go through all the different, you know, AC, DC voltage scales or anything. Now, of course, it's not as accurate in this mode, but if you just want to check something at your house, you just turn it to here. It automatically switches from AC to DC, whatever line that you're checking. And I think that's great. Now it also has the alternating current, direct current, millivolts, ohm test, and if you just want to check to see if you have a wire that's, you know, solid or broken, well, it's actually got a little beeper on there where you can check the continuity as well. So I'm saying the Fluke, this one right here, the 114, is the best meter on the market that you can buy today.
So I know a lot of people are going to say, oh, no, this meter's better, that meter's better. Well, there's all kinds of great meters out there. This is my opinion. I've dropped this meter. I've went out in the rain with this meter. I've used this meter like so much. And you know what? I've tested this meter. I got all kinds of other meters to test stuff with. And that's what I like to do, is I like to actually look at a meter, take a reading, then I get my Fluke 287 out, and I says, can I get the same reading or really close to it? Because if you have a defective meter like I had when I was up there checking my my Kubota tractor, it was throwing me way off. So you got to verify it with something else, right? And this is what I took out. Now I also verify this once in a while, and I verify all the other ones. Because how do you know if you're looking at a multimeter, you're looking at the reading, if it's way off, the first thing I think is, well, something's broke, or this is broke. So I mean, to me, well, I've learned my lesson about using the really cheap bottom feeding meters, because you know what, you get a real cheap bottom feeding reading half the time too, because they work great when you first buy them, and I have checked them with my good meters. They work great. They're not that accurate, but they're close enough for what I need a lot of times when you're testing. But you drop them a couple of times or you go and check something out in the rain, or you bang it around a little bit, the next thing you know, you're reading voltage that just doesn't make sense, or it could be any other, meter reading. So I've learned my lesson, and then somebody asked me, Steve, just for the regular do-it-yourselfer, Fluke 114 is the one that I would suggest. I think I paid $75. I don't know what they are now. They could be $200. I have no idea. But I'm saying this is the best meter for the average just homeowner, do-it-yourselfer. This is the one I recommend. Thanks for joining me here today. If you haven't seen this channel before, you're regular, subscribe. See some more interesting things you just might not see somewhere else. Cheers.